In addition to good morning, good evening, say namaste.
Namaste.
The morning may not be good, evening may not be good, namaste is the good. What does that mean? The te means that unknown, invisible, unknown, unknowable entity which makes my heart beat. Right? A seed becoming a tree, sperm, ovum becoming a human being, oxygen, nitrogen together, air, it is separated into oxygen given to me here. When I am talking, it is digesting my food. Alright? That's God. So he is telling you, namaste. Te meaning, you are that. And you are also God. Okay? To come to Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan is come like coming to on a pilgrimage, according to me. I knew Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan from 1952. Ramakrishnanji and I have worked together on many projects. And C. Subramaniam was chairman. We have worked a great deal in Bombay and so on. So I thank everybody concerned for having given me a chance to address you today on spirituality, or I would say leadership. Now I am an old man, 87 year old. If you want to live long, you should be a very spiritual person. Alright. Look at what's happening in the IT company. They are making 10 lakhs and 15 lakhs and 50 lakhs salary, right? Do you think they are happy?
No.
Everybody is very tense, target-oriented, purposeless, meaningless life. By the time Friday comes, they are exhausted, energy is gone. Thank God that they are in India. When they come home, their wives are safe. In any other country, she won't be there. So on Friday night, because they don't know what to do, they will go on jumping and dancing and singing. Behind my house, there are 5 IT companies, 5 big buildings. Whole Friday night or Saturday night, they will be shouting, IT, BT, Shilpa, Shetty, IT. Why? No purpose in that. Why am I born? All of us live for 20,000 to 30,000 days in our life. How long you live is not important. How you live is important. So if there is a purpose in life, a goal, aim, meaning, ideal in life, then we have fulfilled. Okay, I want you to first of all a prayer for the whole world to be happy. We are the only institution, religion, not religion, civilization in the whole world which has said the whole world should be happy. It not say Kannadiga only should be happy, Bangalore only should be happy, only Tamilians should be happy. Let the whole world be happy. You are unique in that. You can see all other cultures in the world. Out of 49 civilizations which existed prior to the Christian era, ours is the only one which is still living and vibrant. Rome, Egypt, Athens, Chaldonian, Macedonian, Euphrates, Tigris, Inca, Maya, everything gone. Look at Greece, which is a fountain of where Western civilization is dead, whereas India is coming up. Materially in some sense, spiritually much more. Now I am telling you one thing which you will remember, because you have got another 40-50 years to go, or much more than that. That is going to be India's century. Swami Vivekananda in 1895 declared in Chicago, not Chicago, Michigan, that you Americans, this century is your century. 21st century will be India's century. And the whole world of scholars, philosophers, scientists, technologists, professionals, businessmen will come to India to learn how to lead a life. Western countries have become sick. Families have broken down. In America, 5 out of 10 marriages break. Love, affection, all that is gone. I love pizza. I love hamburger. What about your wife? No, that is separate. Even elementary affection to parents and children are gone. And therefore, you are lucky to be born at this time. First of all, Janduna Narajanma Durlabha. To get a human birth, it's a great privilege. You are not a monkey or a donkey or a mosquito or a crocodile. But bit of each of these animals are with you. I used to say when I go to Delhi, same taxi company for 35 years. I tell him, take me to Crocodile Bhavan, he knows where to go. Each one of our bhavans there, Shastri Bhavan, Crocodile Bhavan, Fox Bhavan, because where they enter, they treat you what a fox will treat you. So the fundamental principle is you are born in India. That's a greater privilege. We are the only civilization which has never attacked any other country. Every other country has attacked every other country. We never went to convert anybody. Nobody has been converted. In my family, one of my close relatives has married a Muslim girl. She telephones me, Tata, I'm already a Hindu. I tell him, we don't tell others, just keep quiet. We are born in India because we are the only country which accepts all religions as true. Ishwar Allah Terena, Ekam Sadhu Vipra Vivitha Vadandi. We are the only country with vegetarianism, Ahimsa Paramo Dharma. We are the only country where women are worshipped. All our goddesses are women. Durge Bhagavati, Devi Maheshwari, Katyayani, Devi Rajarajeshwari, Umashangani Parvati, and so on. Whereas in Western countries, women have become chattels. Look at Times of India or Hindustan Times or any paper. Every page has got 3 photographs of women. Front view, back view, side view. Some like the back view. They found out the market research which you don't. By making women chattels for advertisement. True or not true? Therefore, I want you to know that we are the only country where Rama is known as Sitayaha Pati. Sita Pati. Ramasya Pati is not there. Umapati. Girija Vallabha. And also, early morning when you get up, you should say, Karagre Vasade Lakshmi. All over what money? Karamadhyaya Saraswati. You are learning. Karamore Siddha Gauri. Papade Karadarshanam. As soon as you get up, you should say, thank you Mother Earth. Thank you Lakshmi. Thank you Saraswati. All symbolic. Now conditions have changed so much in the last 20, 30 years, particularly in Kerala where I come from. Kerala people say, Karagre Vidikuti, Karamadhyaya Kalugupi, Karamole Chicken Curry. And therefore, first thing to be said is, you are lucky to be born in India. Plus, at this time in history, not like Mr. Vishwanathan Ramdas and others, because they are all on the way back. But we are going to see India's century. Is there a proof? I am giving you a proof now. There are more temples in India today than at any time in history. There are more TV channels today than any time in history. There are more Swamijis today in India than any time in history, even as today. Ramananda Swami and Chaturvedi Swami together met the Chief Minister. And therefore, this is a country to be born. You have to go through Sahasra Kodi Yoni. Sahasra Kodi Yoni. Thousand crore birth and death you have to go through to be born in India. And now, luckily for you, you are born now. Finally, you have taken management as a subject, which is the most profound, most spiritual, most philosophical, most ethical, most moral, most versatile profession in the whole world. Don't take management as what people are normally teaching in the MBA program. Planning, organizing, motivating, directing, controlling, inventory control, production control, expert, CPM, marginal costing. That's one part. But management is much more than that. Much more than that. Which is what I'm going to describe to you in the next half an hour or so. That is management. We civilization began with technology at one end, management at the other. Civilization has progressed because application of technology. Ulakat, now we have high-speed trains or high-speed planes at one end. When I first time broke my leg, it took 6 months. Now, this morning you break your leg, evening you can go for a walk. Women used to give, after delivery, they had to stay for 56 days in the bed. Today they are going in the morning, literally, and going back to work in the evening. Tremendous technology has taken. Heart surgery if you like, eye surgery if you like, whatever. Technology and new technology is coming up again. Brain technology is coming so much, by which even sex is going to be mechanized. All what you want, some sex, okay, put on. Take a barber shop. 10 minutes if you want, okay, 10 minutes. Switch off. So tremendous technological development are taking place all over the world. But along with technological development, a lot of harm also has been. Mother Earth has been harmed. Global warming, desertification, soil erosion, pollution, you name it, any part if you take, more crime, more violence, everything in the world has gone going in the wrong way. Conflicts have increased in spite of all the greatness of America. America is in deep trouble financially. Got the idea? In spite of proving that management is their best, they've got about 50,000 management institutes in America. Then why is it America is in trouble? Because it lacks the spirituality behind it or ethical moral base behind it. That's what we are going to discuss today. Alright? So management is not that alone. Everything in the world is management. It's just like God. I should tell you how. Walking, talking, eating, mating, speaking, whatever you do, there's a management component there. Example. Suppose you are eating, what do you do? Normally, you should eat the right kind of food. Eat slowly. Munch. Let saliva come. Let enzymes come. Don't talk. Concentrate. Be prayerful. If you do that, the stomach will accept it well. But supposing you are talking and as it happens in IT companies, the company is providing food. Whenever any mouth is open, they push the food. They have no time to eat. So even in eating, walk, talking. Talk only when you necessary. talk briefly, talk sensibly, don't be angry, listen to what he's saying, listen more, talk less, is the management component of talking. Walking, be careful when you walk. And then I came to Bangalore, the whole place was full of roads, no car. Now the whole place is full of cars, no roads. Everything is a ulta. True or not true, that's why I keep my beard also. Because everything is in the wrong place. Hair ought to be here. You can see anything you like. The most people who ought to be in jail are in parliament. The least equipped to rule are in parliament. Most of the ministers don't know anything about what it's all about. Got it? And therefore, why it has happened? Because of wrong application of management. So I'm going to give you the right kind of application to management. And if you understand that, you'll find not only getting a good job, you can get a good job, very lucrative job, everything you can have, but dukkha nivarti sukha prapti manashanti is what people want. Dukkha should go. Dukkha means many things of dukkha, physical pain, mental agony, anguish, stress, strain, tension, anxiety, fear, inferiority complex, depression, feeling of being humiliated, harassed, all that should be removed. Who will remove that? We have all this problem of tension, stress, true or not true, particularly managers. Unlike engineering, I can make this table exactly like the way you want. In management, you can never say. One can have happen this way or that way. Now, a king of joy, king of big time, not big time. Good time. Where is your position now? What all is boasting? Fundamental principle is not to boast. Look at Abdul Kalam. Everybody invites him. I'm so humble. He'll call everybody sir. When I went to see him, he caught up from his chair, came to that side, sat with me. Guruji, you made me a happy man today. Will Malaya say it? All managers want to be aggressive. And living in high buildings, luxury. Of prosperity in the body, whereas poverty in the mind. True or not true? Who is happy? Whether it's Devagoda or whatever, all of them are they happy? They are not happy at all. They're all dukkhis. So the purpose of management is dukkha nivarti sukha prapti. Sukha, santosha, ananda, ahlada, joy, a sense of fulfillment, a joy of being ecstasy. That's what we need in life. Right? And that particular part of it has never been dealt with in America, fortunately. Now this is the 50th year I'm talking. I've been talking on ethics, morals, values, philosophy, spirituality, etc., etc. For the last 50 years. Now, 52 American universities are teaching Bhagavad Gita in MBA program. MBA program, Bhagavad Gita is an essential curriculum in 52 American universities. The US Congress starts the program with a recitation from the Vedas. Tacham yora vrnimahe. Gadum Mejnaya Pade, which I can't do it in India. But the US Congress starts. Seven US legislatures start. Bhadram Garne Vishunayama Deva. Always look at the good things. Bhadram Vashema. Always look, hear good things. Sire Ringai Sustu Vagam Sastanubi
Be contented with what you have. Accept the reality. Woman cannot become man, man cannot become woman. You can't change your face, I can't change mine. What can be done? How to optimize, make the best of what we have. That's what we should do. That's all management is all about. Now, conventionally, you all know management is supervision, human relations, coordination, communication, control, planning, etc., etc., etc. All of you know. That's not what that I'm going to speak about. What I'm going to speak about is this word management, administration, governance are the three things which you have. Supervision, right? To get things done, is one thing which you want to do. Two, good human relations, if people like you. And good coordination, good communication. Unless you communicate well, they won't be able to follow what they are saying.